Okay, let's see if we can get some dry fly action here. There was some action before, but nymph is definitely better and fish are larger. This spot seems like a good dry fly spot. Medium fast, medium deep, relatively easy for presentation. So I'll start from downstream and work my way upstream. Okay. First, I'll start close to me. My tippet is relatively long, like 1.5 meters maybe. And I have elk caddis at the end of my tippet. I'll work these spots where I intend to stay, to stand. So, just in case, because the fish can be there, and it is very often. Under the rock, but ooh, this one's crazy. Right. I have to check my tippet after this because it went under the rock, so I had to give it a spike. Lenok trout, elk caddis. Oh. Weird angle, even though it's barbless. Good. So after a fish, run my tippet over the stone. This is my tippet, so arm line and a little bit more. It's 6x. Caddis Y. So my intention is to create a lot of slack without any special tests. Although I do a little bit tuck back with my line. So I create a little bit of slack in my tippet. Now I will try a stone fly that my friend Marco made. Just add some float onto it. Okay. Now let's fish it. Maybe they want something good. Yes. Even though I didn't see stoneflies in this river ever, I guess that there are some. But there are also other insects that probably have this size here. So, nice fish. Really nice. Whoa, and helpful. Okay, I'm still using Marco's stonefly. And this spot over here looks like it can hold some fish. So I approached it behind this rock. I have a really long leader and tippet, almost 2 rod lengths. So it's a bit tricky to cast this fly, but never mind. I'll try something like nymphing technique now, but with a dry fly. Ah, Again, what's wrong with my fly? Nothing wrong. Good thing is I didn't touch any of these fly, any of these fish, so they may repeat. I hope it is. Well, I can switch nymph fishing now, because maybe they will take nymph. They should at least. Decent fish. Oh, very nice fish. Fuck. I had to pull it hard because it's a rock and it wanted to go under the rock. Never mind. Let's do it again. Now, after I lost fish over there and I missed several, I'll try this spot here. I also want to try to come to it from a little bit downstream, and I'll stay low, hiding behind these rocks as much as I can, because I want to come close. I hope fish won't go downstream or I'll be running. Oh my god, it swallowed the whole stonefly. Okay, this is what I do. I put my finger like this and just push the fly so I don't damage the fish. Lost my fly. I'm an idiot. Definitely I'm an idiot. I'm suspecting that there is fish over there, but let's check it. Not a big fish, but the current is strong. You can see the best way to fight it here. Up, up, up. Go this way. Yep. These fish are strong. This spot looks very promising, so I will try to fish this one first, but let me do this one so I can approach from behind. Now I'll try this spot here. From the upstream side, not very good, but who knows? Oh. I want to take it upstream so we can cross current downstream. Yep, not so big. Oh, good. I'm using wiggle mayfly nymph. There is a video of it on my channel. I'll put my nymph in slow water, let it sink, and then just swing it in the current and hope that something will eat it. Yep, like this. Looks like decent sized fish. No, it's okay.